Hey everyone, so in this video I'll be doing an unboxing and installation of this Tiny Toes Lite Tricycle by R4Rabbit. And before we get to the unboxing part, let's see the different details that are mentioned on this box. So the first thing that we have here on the box is the image of the tricycle. So this is how this model looks. And then on the side we've got the features and some different specifications listed here. So it says that it's EN71 and IS9873 certified for safety. Then you get plug and play wheels. Then the next thing that we have is a stylish push bar with direction control. So this is a parental control bar, and it's very good when your kid is like small and can't move the handle in some direction. Then you can assist your kid with this directional control, and you also get a comfortable seat. And the last thing that's mentioned here is about the age group. So this product is suitable for kids between 1.5 years to 5 years. And then on the side we have additional information about the product model, the color, which is pink in my case, and then some additional technical details about the size and the weight. And then there's the same information on the back and on the other side as well. So let's quickly unbox this thing and see what all we've got inside. Alright, so these are the different items that we got in the box. Let's take a look at each one of them. So this one right here is the main frame of the cycle. Then we've got the handlebar. This is the parental control bar, along with some attachment that I think will sit under the frame. And then here we have the front fork to which the wheels will be connected. And this is the seat with the safety harness. And then these are the three wheels. The one with the pedals is the front wheel. And finally, we've got the user manual and some additional attachments. So you might think that these are a lot of parts to assemble, but it really takes only a few minutes as most of the parts are plug and play. So yeah, let's get to the assembly part. So for the installation part, there are detailed steps in the user manual that comes with this product, and along with that you also get these different tools that you might need to fix these things together. And maybe the order in which I am putting things together might be different, but you can stick to the order that's mentioned in the user manual. So the first thing that I'm going to attach are these rear wheels. So let's remove this protective stuff out, and then you just basically need to push this the wheel in from here, and it gets locked automatically. So you might have noticed that clicking sound. So that ensures that the wheel is tight and secure and in place. Now let's do the same for the other wheel as well. Now next we'll assemble the front fork and the handlebar assembly. So for that, this is the pad like thing. It's a mudguard like thing that you get, and you need to place it in here, in this gap over here. So this is how the fork would look like after placing it in. And then let's remove this nut and bolt. And then this thing would slide in from the bottom. So this thing had come off while I was pushing this in, so let me place this back in. And now for attaching the handlebar, you get this little cover like thing that you need to place over here. and then we need to push the handlebar from the top. So let me just move the camera a little bit away. So this is how it looks so far from a distance. And now to secure the handlebar, we need to place the nut and bolt in the gap given over here. So yeah, let me just adjust the camera angle properly so that you can see what's happening. So now that we have got the bolt in, let's tighten the screw. So for after you're done tightening this nut with your fingers, secure it with this tool that they've given in the packaging. So that's done. Now before we attach the front wheels, I'll be securing this mud flap with the screw that has come in the packaging. And for doing that, I'll be making use of the screwdriver part of this tool. So that's tight and secure as well. Now let's attach the front wheels. So for attaching the front wheels, here again we need to take the nut and bolt out first. So on the fork you have two nuts and two bolts, so take those out. And then we'll place the fork in the grooves that are provided for the front tire. And now let's place the nut and bolt back in and tighten this up. Now here again, to secure these two nuts and bolts properly, you need to make use of the tool that I had shown earlier. So just ensure that it's tight and secure. So you can see that we have tightly secured both the bolts for the fork, and they are tight and secure. So this is an important step, guys. You need to be careful that you tighten them properly, because otherwise it would create a safety hazard. And one more thing that I would like to point out over here is that I've kept the flat side pointing towards the back, and the pointed stuff is towards the front of the cycle. So we've attached most of the things so far, and now it's time to attach the parental control handle. So this goes in over here, and if you notice, there's a little release button kind of a mechanism. Now this needs to be pointing towards the back, where it has a little latch like thing. Yeah, so that's also fixed in properly, and it won't come out unless and until you press this release latch. And this right here is an important part that connects the front fork to the parental control arm, which will eventually allow you to control the direction of the cycle. So connecting this is a little bit tricky, so pay careful attention on this part. So the first thing that we need to do is take off this nut, and then this is the end that will go towards the control arm. So you need to place it in over here. and then pull this thing towards the top, and then this front section will go in the fork. So after that's done, the screw that we had taken in needs to be tightened from the bottom of this section. So now with that thing connected, you can easily change the direction of the front wheel using this control arm. Now we are left with attaching the seat and this little fancy item, which is the bell. So yeah, let's quickly attach that. So this is the seat that we have. Here again, take the bolts out. And then after placing the seat in the proper position, you need to push these bolts back in, and then we'll tighten the nuts from the bottom side of the cycle. So first we'll place the washer like thing inside, and then we'll tighten the bolts. So for attaching the seat, it might be a bit tricky, and I would recommend using both of these tools. So you'll use this spanner to hold the nut in place, and from the other end, you'll tighten the bolt. So the bolt has a screw-like thing, and you can use this tool to basically tighten it from the top. So I've attached the seat properly, and now it's tight and secure. And now comes the final part of the installation. This is a fancy little bell which you can place on the handlebar. So let me unscrew the screw, and then we'll fix it on the handlebar. So we are done with the complete installation now, and if you have any questions about this tricycle or the assembly instructions in general, please feel free to add those in the comment section below. So thank you guys for watching this video, and do subscribe to my channel.